Hello everyone, myself Shivani Saxena from Sri Vaishnav Vidyapeeth Vishwavidyalaya, presenting my topic Reason Behind Commission of Cybercrime. Content, Introduction, Cybercrime, Reason, Rate of Cybercrime in India, How to Protect Yourself, and last is Conclusion. Crimes are not be measured by the issue of event, but by the bad intentions of men. The greatest crime do not arise from a want of feelings for others, but from an over-sensibility for ourselves and an over-indulgence in our own desire. Crime. The expression crime is defined as an act which subjects the doer to legal punishment of any offense against morality, social order, or any unjust or shameful act. Offense. The offense is defined in the Code of Criminal Procedure to mean as an act or omission made punishable by any law for the time being in force. Now come on cybercrime. Cybercrime is criminal activity done using computers and the internet, such as hacking, phishing, etc. Reason of cybercrime. There are three key reasons. Financial gain. This is the primary motivation for the majority of attacks. The cyber criminal is looking for either an immediate or indirect financial gain. Second one is corporate information. Attackers who target corporate information are also looking for a financial gain. Home users and offices are a good starting point of cyber criminals looking to get corporate information. Cyber criminals will target home networks to see how much information they can get, which they could then use against the company or in another type of attack. And the last one is egostaticals. The attackers is not seeking financial gain, but recognition, acknowledging that they have the skill and knowledge to defeat the security. This reason is far less common than the first two. Rate of cybercrime in India. We see the increasement of the statistics in comparison to 2011, 12, 13, 14, and 15. We see where in 2011, 13,301 cybercrime, and in 2015, 3 lakh cybercrime is registered. So we can see the statistics and the increased rate of cybercrime in India. How you can protect yourself? Keep your information secure. Second one, put the necessary control on your home networks to protect your family from cybercrime. Prevent identity theft when shopping online or using contactless payment. Keep your children safe when using the internet. Now we come on the conclusion. As internet technology advances, so does the threat of cybercrime. In time like these, we must protect ourselves from cybercrime. Antivirus software, firewalls, and security patches are just the beginning. Never open suspicious email and only navigate trusted site. Thank you.